on tonight's Off Camera, film director Roman Polanski may be plotting a return to the United States. He fled the country 10 years ago after pleading guilty to a sex charge involving a 13-year-old actress in one of his films. Polanski's attorney has asked prosecutors in Los Angeles, though, to look into what would happen if the director returned to American soil. L.A. Law co-star Jimmy Smith owes the city of Los Angeles $150 and 50 hours of community service. He pleaded no contest today to charges of disturbing the peace. He was arrested in August during an argument with his girlfriend. Network executives at NBC have finally figured out why the detective series Private Eye just isn't working. It's been riding at around number 60 in the ratings, but it's not the script or storylines, it's apparently the lead actor. NBC Entertainment Chief Brandon Tartikoff has ordered the show's producers to fire actor Michael Woods, or the show will be canceled.
Number 60, huh? More news coming up at 6. John Postal is live in the news right now. John?
Well, we're hoping everybody has a good time tomorrow, but at 6 tonight, we'll tell you what the CHP is planning to keep the roads safe for holiday drivers. And speaking of the holiday, how to keep your figure during these delicious times. To do with these stories, a lot more coming up on Action News a half hour from now.
Okay, thank you, John. Any cook will tell you the traditional Thanksgiving dinner takes a lot of preparation, and it becomes more complicated if 30 preschoolers are cooking it. But as Norma Confield reports, a local daycare center believes the result is worth all the trouble.
It's hard work carrying on this tradition the pilgrims started. Little hands can't always snap a string bean, but these guys were sure willing to try. Finishing the final steps of preparing this meal they've been working on for a week. Even buttering their homemade banana bread takes concentration, but they know they'll appreciate it in the end.
What's your favorite part about Thanksgiving?
I'm going to have bread and green beans and meat.
You like Thanksgiving?
Yes.
Why?
Because I like to eat it.
And sharing things is a way of saying thank you, isn't it? Are we going to have a feast?
Of course, there's some behind-the-scenes kitchen help for this feast, but the kids are involved enough to know this meal didn't come easy.
And besides being a good lunch, they figure this is a good hands-on lesson for the kids as well.
You give them a chance to just really be successful, and the product is not the important thing, it's the process, and the way they feel about themselves and the accomplishment is real important.
Besides, lessons on a full stomach are much easier to swallow. Norma Concio, Channel 30, Action News.
I bet those lucky parents enjoyed every minute of it.
Yeah, you need some help in the kitchen tomorrow,
I could use some, yeah.
You've got all those little guys to help you. And that is our news. ABC's World News Tonight is up next.
And we'll be back tomorrow night, live at 5. Until then, have a good night.
Good night.
Chicago is not just any city, and when the mayor of Chicago, Harold Washington, died suddenly this afternoon, the shock in that city was enormous. The mayor was an immensely powerful man, and one veteran political
murder and an entire neighborhood had to be evacuated earlier today because of it. 37-year-old Jerry Lee Norris made an unwelcome entrance into the house where his estranged wife, son, and in-laws were gathered by driving his car into it. No one was hurt in the crash, but there were some injuries from a minor fight that followed. Norris, who apparently has some experience with explosives, had called just before the incident threatening to blow the house up. Half a dozen neighboring homes were evacuated during the search for a bomb in his car. None was found. Just who are the members of the bomb squad who risked their lives when explosives were found or suspected? Tonight, a closer look at the bomb squad members and how they go about their dangerous duty. Kevin Cox is standing by live now with more. Kevin?
Hello, Liz. Bomb squad members come from here, the Fresno Police Department. They come from the Clovis Police Department. They also come from the Fresno County Sheriff's Office. And these officers volunteer for this duty. to be on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, to go out to incidences such as the one this morning in Clovis, what you might call potentially explosive situations.
I'm home on Thanksgiving, nurturing a cold and fixing breakfast for my family and relatives, and suddenly the phone rings and here I am.
Fresno Police Sergeant Jim Jones and Clovis Police Specialist John Reynolds have 31 years of combined experience on bomb squads. Others stand back or even take cover as Jones and Reynolds begin their work. At about 9 o'clock this morning, a man considered to be a demolitions expert threatened to blow up his estranged wife and her family in Clovis, then drove his car into the side of their house. The bomb could be inside of the trunk, and the only way to find out is to open it.
Say a prayer. Hold your breath a little bit and walk softly. And just try and be as careful as you can.
There isn't a bomb in the trunk, but Jones and Reynolds still have to search the front of the car. A tow truck pulls the car out of the house. Then the two men continue to look for suspicious wires or anything else that isn't supposed to be there. This search turns out the way everyone had hoped. No bomb, just a threat. So Jones and Reynolds become off-duty police officers again and head off to celebrate Thanksgiving.
I'm hoping I can get back for turkey. That time of season. I enjoy the adrenaline rush that comes out of it. If I didn't, I'd be lying to you. That living on the edge, it makes people feel good. You know, some people need something in their life to make it a little more active than sitting behind a desk.
I talked to some brave cops who wouldn't dare do what Jimmy Jones and John Reynolds do. A little more about the bomb training that these officers go through. There are bomb training schools, intensive training schools in the military and that the FBI offer. And most of the officers have gone through those. There are, in addition, monthly meetings of the bomb squad members, the seven or eight of them that make up the Fresno Clovis Metropolitan Area Bomb Squad. Those are monthly meetings, plus follow-up courses. Jim Jones is on his way up to Sacramento to go to a week-long bomb seminar offered by the FBI. Reporting live from downtown Fresno at the police department, Kevin Cox, Channel 30 Action News.
Thank you, Kevin. No holiday either for Justice Department officials still struggling to end a pair of prison seizures being staged by human inmates. The situation remains virtually unchanged tonight, and the authorities say prospects for a settlement anytime soon look dim. At the Atlanta Penitentiary, 40 inmates did give themselves up today, but hundreds of others continue to hold 94 people hostage. No progress is reported in talks with inmate leaders, but the Justice Department continues to give assurances they will not storm the prison while the hostages are safe. Attorney General Ed Meese reassured the families of the hostages in a phone call this afternoon.
Reported to be safe, and their safety continues to be our number one concern.
In Louisiana, where 28 more hostages are being held, no progress in negotiations, but officials report that communication with the inmates is improving. The families of the hostages gathered for a Thanksgiving prayer vigil over dinner. The Salvation Army also providing dinners to hostage families in Atlanta on this Thanksgiving Day. There is a hopeful sign for a pair of French hostages being held in Lebanon. A pro-Iranian group delivering a note to a Beirut newspaper today saying two French hostages would be set free in the next 24 hours. And all 22 foreigners are being held in Lebanon, among them eight Americans and Church of England envoy Terry Waite. In the Philippines, thousands are homeless and nearly 300 people are dead, the victims of Typhoon Nina. It is the 15th typhoon that has struck the Philippines this year, but the most powerful one in 6 years. Hardest hit are coastal areas south of Manila. Shelters have been established and President Aquino has declared a state of emergency. Hundreds of people in Chicago today gathered in churches to mourn the death of Mayor Harold Washington. His sudden passing of a heart attack yesterday will trigger a battle among city aldermen over who will succeed him. Jesse Jackson's name has surfaced as a possible candidate, but he says he's not interested. At the foot of the nation's capital, as in many places around the country on this Thanksgiving Day, the needy and homeless were given free meals. In Fresno, hundreds of poor were treated to a turkey dinner at the Pavarello House, and one family whose car broke down walked 3 miles to eat together at the Holy Cross Center. A traditional family celebration of Thanksgiving coming up on Live at 5, plus part 4 in our Health Watch series, The Courage of Children. Tonight, the positive prospects for longevity among childhood cancer patients.
I'm really lucky that I didn't die. watches, socks, and videotapes here. I got the Christmas barrel here. And the free coffee and donuts. Join us for our fantastic four-hour sale from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. on the day after Thanksgiving at Payless.
It's the season to shop Sprouse Rice for the right price. $19.97 for West Bend Electric Wok or Skillet or Presto Hot Topper. $21.97 for Toastmasters Round Waffle Maker. Just 77 cents for Q-Tex Nail Polish Remover. $1.67 for Vaseline Intensive Care Lotion. Special sale prices, too, on Prince Machiavelli fragrances in your choice of two sizes, plus a $2 mail-in rebate. Make the holidays right. Shop Sprouse Rice. Super 7 sale. We're clearing out our 87 Chryslers with our best savings ever. 7-7 financing, plus $770 back and 770 protection on LeBaron GTS, coupe, and convertible. It won't last forever, so hurry.
Buy one at your Fresno area Chrysler Plymouth dealers today.
Last chance for big savings during Gutschalk's November home sale. Look for the Gutschalk insert in Friday's paper and save on china, cookware, and furniture at Gutschalk.
When the Don Jones family of Fresno sat down at the table today for turkey and dressing, it was a three-generation operation. Always has been, and probably always will be. As with many American families, the Jones family Thanksgiving is built on tradition. Betty Jones' kitchen has been buzzing since 6 o'clock this morning. She was busy stuffing two turkeys, fixing a platter of mashed potatoes, fresh fruit salad, yams, and apples, and hot rolls for 17. Betty and her husband, John Jones, have been hosting the family Thanksgiving dinner since John retired from the Air Force in 1970.
We have the whole family together, and it's always basically the same group, and it gets larger. It's always at Mom's house.
The family gathering has been as large as 38 and 40 people. This year's guest list of 17 is by far the shortest, but Betty Jones has dinner under control no matter who shows up.
We've got it down pat. We don't need that much planning. Between my sister and I, we'll just tell everybody what we want and they just do it.
Most of the guys watch TV, the kids get in the way, and in the foreman of the kitchen, I watch them cut up everything and make sure they do it right.
After several hours of sniffing and nibbling, the best part of the Jones Thanksgiving tradition finally comes to pass.
Chaos! It's always that way, but we always have a lot of fun, so that's why we do it.
This little one missed out on all the fun, or maybe she's just taking a rest before dessert. There are a number of restaurants that prepare Thanksgiving dinners for those who prefer to go out on this holiday. Ernie's Elderberry House in Oakhurst is one such place, but there, reservations for today's feast are booked in advance. Juanita Stevenson tells us why Ernie's place is so special.
Over the river and through the woods to Oakhurst, there you will find Ernie's Elderberry House. Restaurant you'd expect to find in Europe. That's exactly what Erna had in mind when she built this place 3 years ago.
When I built the Elderberry House, although it is a new house, I try to maintain antiquity. So I like to bring the feel of the place has been here for a long time.
There are four dining rooms, all elegantly furnished. They are cozy and romantic. But here at the Elderberry House, it's what goes on in the kitchen that's exciting.
A great software, the Coco Vine.
Erna and her partner Fernando plan the menus a week in advance. Preparing the food can take most of the day.
Sometimes it's quite a challenge. We do something different every night, and therefore we want to, you know, be creative, but it can't be boring.
Everything is fresh, from the produce to the herbs, and when it's finished, it looks as good as it tastes.
It is a joy for the eye as well. And we always, it's a big creation every mealtime to come out and study.
And it is Erna's guests who benefit from all this.
It's an outstanding experience. It's a romantic experience. The food is excellent. The food is worth the drive, worth the trip.
project that will make the trip to Oakhurst much easier. Guests won't have to leave. A country inn is being built on the same property. Juanita Stevenson, Channel 30 Action News.
You drive in the car, then you go home, and then you open the turkey, and then you put it in the oven for hours, and I don't know what to wear.
Well, last week here on the Big Spin, we gave away over $250,000. Hi, I'm Jeff Edwards, saying it often happened to you. All you have to do is play our new surprise package game, and one day it could be you up here spinning for millions. Really, it's just that easy. So make plans to play along with us right here on this station, Saturdays at 7, as we go in search of the next Californian to win $1 million or more. And who knows, just might be you.
The Big Spin, Saturday night at 7, only on Channel 30.
The best-built, best-selling full-size pickup in America. Now drive a new F-150 for only $117 a month. That's right, $117 a month. Now get $500 cash back from Ford on F-150. And we'll throw in the $395 value Ford Bedliner for only $117. F-150, $117 a month, $500 cash back, and a Bedliner for $117.
Ford Fever, get it now.
You're watching Channel 30 Action News, the Valley's number one newscast. Still to come, Angelo Stavros and the AccuWeather Forecast.
The gifts you need are here indeed. Make just one stop where it's fun to shop. Dot Socks, especially at Christmas. Slip in the men's and women's slippers with terrific savings and get an extra gift as you cash in on our buy one, get one free special. Choose from women's cozy quilted warm-up boots and printing solids, just $10. And men's quilted warm-up boots and corduroy espadrilles, just $13. And when you buy one pair, get one pair free. Perfect for Christmas gift giving in the hosiery department at Dot Socks.
If you're using Roundup instead of Gramoxone Super, you're burning a lot more than weeds. Gramoxone Super, still $7 to $10 less per acre.
In the 1950s, kids with cancer simply died. Medicine wasn't able to help them. Today is a very different time, though, and as Nancy Osborne reports in the conclusion of her Special Health Watch series, the courage of children coping with cancer has helped change the once dismal outcome.
Lucky that I didn't die.
It may seem strange to hear an 11-year-old talk about living, but he knew full well he might have died. Childhood cancer has a way of altering not just your life, but the way in which you live it. Little ones, too, know the bad guys can kill them, yet today cancer isn't winning as often as it did 20, 15, even 10 years ago.
This isn't just surviving for 2 years and then dying, or surviving for 3 years and then dying. This is a 50% overall cure rate where the child grows up, goes to school, makes friends, is a member of his family.
Each of the most common childhood cancers carries different odds. Hodgkin's disease, a lymphoma, is cured upwards of 80% of the time. Brain tumors, between 30 and 40%. And depending upon the type of leukemia, 50 to 80-plus percent of the time.
There's even success for these children and for their families in making it comfortable for them, even if they have to lose their lives to the cancer.
The one ingredient medicine can't provide is the positive attitude of a child's family, but it's essential to successful treatment.
Every morning I woke up and I said, God, today's a new day, you know, may it be better.
He's had a positive attitude, he takes everything well, and he's a fighter.
Things are better now. There's a long ways to go and a lot of research still to do, but things are better.
How do you get through it?
Well, you just know that she's going to get better. There's no choice, really. You got to do it.
Are you getting used to the idea that you're going to be around a while?
Not every child with cancer survives, but the progress made over the last 10 or 15 years provides real hope to more than half of them, and those are odds the kids and their parents can live with. Nancy Osborne, Channel 30 Action News.
The children and the families who were part of Nancy Osborne's Special Health Watch series this week have much to be thankful for on this day. Each child has successfully beaten the cancer into remission. Their courage is an inspiration to us all and a miracle to their families. Something else we can be thankful for today, the weather.
What a gorgeous day outside today, Angelo.
Yeah, didn't it turn out to be real nice?
Yeah, in other parts of the country they weren't so lucky.
Mm. Yeah, snow over the Rockies, over the Colorado Rockies, and snow over the northeastern United States, and some hefty totals in those two sections of the country. But out here in the west, high pressure keeping things pretty nice, at least through today. We do expect the weathermakers to bring some showers to northern California by tomorrow, if you're thinking of traveling up to the northern Sierra. Be aware of that. Be prepared for some winter driving conditions if you're heading up to the northern Sierra, like the Lake Tahoe area or northern California. Could be some showers tomorrow and Saturday. Numbers today, though, recovered from yesterday's fog over the central San Joaquin Valley. Fresno, excuse me, hitting a 60, and the overnight low was really a cold one, 30 degrees in Fresno. And there were some upper 20-degree readings over the south San Joaquin Valley. There may be more of those tonight, but we expect the temperatures to be slightly warmer tonight over the valley, so that's good news for citrus growers. The set hit a 55, Los Banos and Madera 59 and 61, Visalia and Sanger 61 and 59, Oakhurst and Shaver in the 50s, Columbia and Hanford in the 60s and 50s, Porterville with a 59, and on this Thanksgiving Day down in Dineva, 61 degrees. And on the satellite picture, we do have a little weather maker that's going to bring us some showers, as we said, over the northern Sierra, Washington and Oregon, northern California, and it could bring us a shower. The upper air portion behind this system here will drop in sometime on Saturday for a chance of a slight chance of a shower of the central San Joaquin Valley. Next system due in early part of next week could bring us some wet weather activity, maybe Monday night or Tuesday or even into Wednesday. But for the time being, high pressure has moved into the state and sort of calmed things down with all the gusty winds that we had over portions of California yesterday, especially over the northern state and over southern California. Things have subsided today, and it really did turn out to be a nice Thanksgiving day for at least much of California. Air quality today turned out to be moderate. It is expected to be that way tomorrow with an agricultural burn day and your exclusive AccuWeather forecast. Here we go with some nice fall foliage in the background there, mostly clear, and a 35 tonight. We had a 30 last night, so we're expecting about a 5-degree warm-up. Some morning fog tomorrow, and then otherwise partly sunny skies, because in the advance of that system, we're going to get some clouds, and the temperatures will fall just a little bit for the daytime high, 58. Right now, we have a 55, and the relative humidity at 47%. The barometer is steady, and the winds are coming in out of the west. Actually, they're calm right now, calm at 2 miles an hour. Huh? How about that? Beautiful, beautiful Thanksgiving Day weather, and a happy one to you.
Thank you. On Tuesday, Dan Whitehurst talked about changing Fresno's system of government to give the mayor more power over what goes on in City Hall. Tonight, a perspective on another idea being kicked around that would also have a dramatic impact on city government.
Some folks are suggesting that Fresno repeal its system of electing council members from districts and go back to the old method of electing all members citywide. Well, I didn't support the charter amendment that brought about the district system. But now that I've seen it for a while, frankly, I would now oppose a return to the old system. Here are the reasons. Running citywide is really expensive. I mean, it's expensive enough to run in a district, but district elections at least allow grassroots candidates to compete for office. Going citywide means you have to be rich or be willing to cater to the moneyed special interest. Also, at-large elections would probably mean that most of the council members would come from the north end of town. West Fresno and Southeast Fresno would likely not have representatives on the council. District elections do give neighborhoods a voice on the council. With that large representative, people don't have a specific person they can turn to when they have a problem. But with district elections, members have to stay in touch with the people and get directly involved when an issue pops up. Of course, there are problems with district elections, but in my view, they're outweighed by the advantages. And anyway, we've only had districts for a short time. In the interest of stability and continuity, let's not tamper with the system at this point. I'm Dan Whitehurst.
Next Monday evening, a commission that's been considering some of these changes in city government will hold a public hearing so you can give your input. The meeting will be at Fresno City Hall Monday at 6:30.
I would make it. Then I would stuff it. Then I would eat it.
It's backed by popular demand. Kaufman's famous Super Sale. Just pick any suit or sport coat from the thousands of top quality famous label fashions in our inventory. Choose another and get a special super price. All season vested suits are 2 for $188. Year-round wool blend suits are 2 for $268. Botany wool blend or custom imperial all wool suits are 2 for $318. Wool blend sport coats are 2 for $138. Only at Kaufman. Good clothes, Goodbye to you. Welcome to one of the greatest ideas in the world, The Orchard, homes by Kesterson Development.
Homes built for family enjoyment, space to live in, and have fun. Incredible room to cook up new ideas. Warm, open, and airy, yet private and comfortable. There's so much here to captivate the imagination.
Visit one of the greatest ideas in the world at The Orchard, an extraordinary new Kesterson community of single-family homes on Sunnyside, just south of Herndon.
Honda, I looked at your Prelude, but I bought the new Chevy Beretta. Why? Well, to start with, I like Beretta's fresh new styling, the extra room inside, and I really like Chevy's 6-year, 60,000-mile protection. But the bottom line? At my Chevy dealer, my Beretta was almost $3,000 less than your Prelude. I love my Beretta. I love the $3,000 savings.
See your newest Northern California Chevy dealer today.
What better way to spend this Thanksgiving Day than to sit back and watch all the football games? You guessed it. That's what Dan Taylor's been doing all day today, right?
How did you guess? I guess it wasn't too hard to figure that out, was it? There's some great football today, too. There's Kansas City and Detroit playing this morning. Former Bulldog star Stephon Paige with a great performance in that one. Kansas City snapped a 9-game losing streak where they beat Detroit in a game later this afternoon. The Dallas Cowboys and the Minnesota Vikings game that went to overtime. Looks like a game that was never going to end before the Minnesota Vikings pulled out a 44-38 victory in that one. So, out of turkey today and a little bit of pigskin flying around to boot to top that menu off. So, a lot of us roller skating is a fun form of exercise, recreation. Another Fresno woman, Sue Fitzpatrick, it is a very competitive sport as we see in tonight's Sports Extra.
Sue Fitzpatrick's road to the National Skating Championships hasn't always followed a straight line. Actually, she never dreamed that skating would take her this far. She only hoped that roller skating would help make her a better skier.
It keeps you in great shape to go skiing, and that's how it started, and now I've caught the bug, and it's just very pleasurable. It's a nice way to set goals, accomplish them, and feel good about yourself.
Now, at National, Sue will compete in dance as well as figure eight. Figure eight may look easy, but it isn't.
There's several things you have to think of. First of all, you want to stay on the line. It depends on how your body's positioned as to whether you'll be on that line or not. If you have one arm a little higher than the other, it will throw you off the line. You can't look straight down at your feet. You've got to aim a little bit ahead of yourself and then keep your hips in a proper position as well as the whole line down the whole body and keep your whole body over your skating knee.
For Sue, preparing for the national championships means workouts of over 2 hours a day, 4 to 5 days a week. She is hoping that back in Springfield, Missouri, it will pay off big with a gold medal.
Well, this Thanksgiving weekend also means a lot of basketball. And locally, Fresno State Sun Met Classic will tip off tomorrow. And we'll have a preview when we come back at 6 o'clock. And Ruth, we're not through with football yet. There's another game later tonight, Texas A&M. When it goes to the Cotton Bowl, there's still a lot of pigskin flying around on Thanksgiving.
Of course, and then more games coming up this weekend.
Oh, of course, even tomorrow there's a couple more games. And a full schedule of college basketball tomorrow. A lot of the big tournaments tip off tomorrow as well. So, what fans' delight?
Your delight, I imagine.
I am very delighted.
Thank you, Dan.
Okay.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Cooking turkey because my mom made it, and she did a pretty good job on it.
The Plymouth Sundance. Compare it side-by-side to Nissan Sentra XC, and you'll find Sundance has 47 standard features with more versatile seating, more power, plus 770 protection they don't have. And Sundance is about $1,000 less, which is exactly why we put a Sentra next to Sundance at your Chrysler Plymouth dealer. You see, putting a Sentra in our showroom may be the best way to put a Sundance in your garage. See it today at your Chrysler Plymouth dealer. This year, add a little character to your holiday celebration.
chips from the Valley's largest selection of Lazy Boy recliners starting as low as $198. Leather recliners start at just $549. And there's more than just chairs on sale. Save on sleep sofas from $499. Most of my